scripture. Right? It says, whatever is there, you have to bomb. Right? Now, in new construction, whatever you're going to provide, you have to bomb. So if I have a PVC system coming from the utility, I don't have to bomb the building as my electrical system. Because it's not bonded in the earth. But if you put it in the plans is a signed document, a legal document, you gotta worry about water flying in. Don't put it in the plans. Nobody mechanical guys ask you for a permit. Right? If you don't have structural steel, there's no need to bomb structural steel. So it's to wake them up that not everything is ridiculous. You have to know what to get. If all you have is two ground rods are sufficient. But that's what's there. If all you have is a water pipe system as long as it is installed properly is sufficient. As long as it's there. Right? We as electricians get a little crazy sometimes. We'll go to a block building with red steel girders and want to bond the steel on the girders for the roof pipe. And how the fuck is that a contract with the earth? It's not. Why are we bonding the steel? It's not a contract with the earth. Now, we may have to bond the steel for accidental contact, but it's not an electric system to dissipate energy. Maybe people understand the differences, the whole way they can do it. Right? Metal underground water pipe, direct contact with the earth for 10 feet or more. Through the metal chase based on bonding pipes, electrical, continuously electrical, so forth and so on. Jumpers needed if necessary. Alright? Now, it does mention it later on, but the minimum size pipe is a 3/4 size outer diameter. So it has to be 10 feet of metal pipe, 3/4 size in earth. If you want to use a water pipe system as a ground and electrical system. Metal membranes in direct contact with the earth for 10 feet or more within the condominium, if you have a big building, it's going to encircle the whole building. Right? They're doing a billion-dollar job on the digesters in South Dade, water treatment plant, and around the digesters, they're going down, 3 feet. Every 10 foot, they drive around a lot. And they have a well-written wire all the way around. But it would make sense, you want to make sure that that thing is very well done, because the digesters have what they pay in gas. So it would be very sensible that you have lightning protection and a good ground system to make sure there's no boom. So that's what they're doing. If that is your, and I extend my thing, if you're designed, if you're trying to get good ground system done for whether it's a computer system or some HVAC, or if you want to prevent lightning from, they're all FTL transformer sites are metal. They're all they do all day long is get hit by lightning. You want to be able to dissipate that energy without injuring your equipment. A ground ring is the way you want to go. Right? That's what that means on the first floor. Of course, you have rods and plates. So, now, ground rod, that's right. What direction can a ground rod be driven? It could be any direction, as long as it has a minimum of, if it's horizontal, a minimum, there has to be foundation here.
Talking
with Seth. Talking with Donald. desire